All right, as we can see, Pono Sports, Reiki Jones in blue at the bottom of the screen, AHQ Yao Yao in red at the top. What are we going to see here?
No Golem, as you mentioned, I think Lava Hound is a high chance here, especially from Yao Yao. Okay, he does show that, hey, just in case, I have a log here. If you're going to use the Rascals, just try to test me. Hog Rider.
Hog Rider is an interesting choice. There's the Electro Wizard. Will slow him down, but he will get two hits in here. Fireball. Nicely done. But that Electro Wizard is not going to do anything to that tower. Gets taken down. Pretty much no HP.
Bull Giant.
What is he doing here?
All of a sudden, has the Infernal Shroud. Infernal Dragon.
Yeah,
himself. So Yao Yao just shakes his head a little bit, saying, oh, that's a bad move.
Still does get a decent connect there, though. A couple of hundred damage is nothing to shake at, especially when playing Royal Giant like this.
Ooh, doesn't have the Valkyrie, but the Hog Rider goes still. No defense whatsoever, just a log.
Hog Rider going to town on that tower. Look how much damage has been done.
Another one.
He just didn't have any elixir to try and defend that at all. That's really bad for Yao Yao at this point in the game. 686 on that tower remaining, and there's still 1 minute 30 left.
With a Hog Rider and Fireball in Reiki Jones' hand, I think that's basically already almost gone, you know? And he does know that the secret winning card for Yao Yao is close to being Royal Giant. And maybe a few more cards available, but seems very unlikely right now.
There's the Fireball. That Fireball now does put that in range of Hog Rider getting at least two hits. We'll take down that tower. And Hog Rider, there's not much to stop the Hog Rider. But the Royal Giant played now. There's the Rascals. Is there the log to answer? It doesn't look like it is. The bats will take down that Royal Giant as well. There's the Hog Rider on the other side. Electro Wizard will slow it down, but is it enough to take it out before he takes out that tower? There we go. Does get that tower. Nice and easy. The Rascal Girl connects with the tower, and there's still a lot of HP left on those towers for Reiki Jones.
50 seconds. 42 now. He's in trouble. Yao Yao, he has to push in, but does he have the space to push? His furnace is all the way in the back. Fireball, that's been ready already, and going for the attack, Reiki Jones. Best offense is the best defense. Another Fireball lands in.
Keeping everything from your opponent on their side of the field does protect your towers better than pretty much anything else.
This has to be everything right now for Yao Yao. This is the only chance. 18 seconds.
Royal Giant gets one, two, will definitely get three, but not a fourth. That's really bad now for Yao Yao. He needs to do 800 damage in next to no turn. Fireball finishes that off. Down goes that defense. Valkyrie will connect once, twice. Will it get a third? Oh, just not enough there. Reiki Jones takes game number one. We got it. But that doesn't matter now. We are down into game number two. Reiki Jones once again in the blue. AHQ Yao Yao in red at the top.
Just to remind you, it is best of five, as this is the only match for today at Winterwood, just advanced. We're the playoff guys.
Yep.
Another one, maybe just the same one from Yao Yao.
The Arches doesn't really tell us much about the dead. There's a Lightning. Doesn't want to see anything about that Electro Wizard. Deletes it instantly.
Shouldn't he be charging up for more damage?
He's not Pikachu in like episode 2 of Pokemon, man. You don't charge him up with that. How can you imagine if you could charge your own units with
like an Iron Man
spell?
Like Thor Electro zaps or Iron Man, he says, and then Friday or the other AI says
Jarvis
charge 300%. No thanks.
Yeah, it would have been super good actually if you could charge your own units with a lightning spell or a zap.
No, but with this band it'll just stops with the Electro Wizard.
Good use. The poison there drops down, will chip away at these units. It does mean those fire spirits won't connect to the tower this time. And we're still very, very even at this point. One fire spirit just creeps out before it dies. And there we have the miner. Inferno Dragon will take that down next to no problems at all, equaling out the towers to 2,100-ish each.
Yeah, so this is a better matchup for Yao Yao. And compared to the last game.
Ooh, Lightning.
Oh,
that was close. That Inferno Dragon was so close to connecting to that tower then. The minions just in time. Unfortunately, the Valkyrie's axe does not go up.
Well, that will be an executioner then. Well, Valkyrie, that's
Look
why she's so strong.
How much damage is being done there. The miner at the back tanked all the damage, allowing the minions to just go ham on that tower, taking it down to 1,058. Yao-Yao once again has his back up against the wall, but we have seen that he is actually good at coming back from that. And Royal Giant again!
It is the same deck again against that P.E.K.K.A. The perfect one to slay Ruth. Only got two shots on that tower.
Yeah, unfortunately, P.E.K.K.A. is such a hard answer to that unit. And the Royal Ghost
P.E.K.K.A. is actually going so close. P.E.K.K.A. does get hit, but the Royal Dragon does go down.
Don't do it. And the tower goes down to the minion anyway. The P.E.K.K.A. tanking most of that up. Can Yao-Yao?
Oh, Yao-Yao already had his fingers off the device. I mean, he only has 12 seconds and that's already game over, I feel.
Yeah, he knows it's over. He doesn't look very happy, of course. Ryky Jones has a smile from ear to ear, but that does conclude set number one. Ryky Jones takes it 2-0. Royal Giant in Clash Royale League Asia. I'm pretty sure that's a 0% win ratio for that card.
Including 2v2 as well. Has not been really putting out great result, I would say.